first time in a long time, we get a recap video out on Monday night. I feel something. I feel completely different, let me tell you. It is a surprising week 15. I was about to say 14 for a second. But week 15 gave us even more questions. It levels out the playing field a little bit for some teams and eliminates some others. Why don't we just go talk about tonight's game first? You have Juju Smith-Schuster dancing on the 50-yard line, and the Steelers lose their third straight game. Three straight games. There has got to be some cause for concern, you know. Excuse me. This team did look 11-0, and then they lost three straight. It is setting the stage up nicely for the Steelers to get bounced early. Now, playoff spots haven't been completely locked up and stuff yet, and now it looks like the Browns have something to say about the division title. And the Ravens. Don't forget about the Ravens, because, you know, I'll talk about the Ravens in a moment. The Browns beat up on the Giants. Pretty easy, breezy. And who does that help? Who does that help with the Giants taking an L? Oh, you know. You know who. But we'll talk about that. And, you know what? Let's just get it out the way right now so you don't have to sit and wait. The Jets won a football game. Honestly, you know, between Juju dancing in the Bengals, you know, end zone and stuff like that, and the 50-yard line and stuff like that, and the Jets winning a game, thus allowing for the Jags to have the number one pick now. Crazy. And the Rams just laid an egg. They really laid a goose egg. Inexplicable. Inexcusable. How do you let the Jets beat you? This is supposed to be the perfect 0-16. We're talking 0-16 perfection. Even better than the Lions. Even better than the Browns. And it's not happening. Not happening at all. Not happening. Rams ruined it. Upset of the season. There's something. I don't know. These Rams are inconsistent as hell, to be completely honest with you. Like, they look good at times. They look like, oh, the second coming of Jared Goff. And they lay goose eggs like this. So, what about the biggest game of the day? Obviously, the Chiefs beat the Saints. Because that what's new with that? I mean, the Chiefs can just lock up the number one seed next week with a W. It's pretty concerning, you know, for Pittsburgh, who just had the number one seed not even 3 weeks ago. And here we are. Chiefs are probably going to be the number one seed in the AFC. And, you know, it was what? I mean, the Saints came back and made it a game. But honestly, watching the Chiefs play, you know, for the most part, gets kind of boring. Yeah, the Saints came back and stuff like that, made it a respectable result. But, I mean, the Chiefs had it in hand. You know, Patrick Mahomes can do no wrong. You know what I mean? I mean, you give him 2 minutes left on the clock, he and Andy Reid and all the other guys that play on the Chiefs just have it. Just have that it factor in them, to where they can get the best results possible. So what about those Cardinals and the Eagles? Cardinals laid a whooping on the Eagles for the most part. Now the Eagles, again, they came back as well, made it a respectable result. Jalen Hurts, you know, unfortunately couldn't get that Hail Mary down at the end. But Cardinals, you're back in good position. You're back in good standing. Good job. So the 49ers, coupled with the Cardinals win, and taking a fat L to my Dallas Cowboys. That's right, my Dallas Cowboys. We are still in the playoff hunt, baby. We still got some things that could, we still have to have some things go our way, but the playoffs, you know, Andy's coming to the postseason. Potentially. Of course, potentially. But, yeah, the 49ers, they just did not look very good for most of that game. You know, they can't, I mean, again, it was another case of, you know, they came back, made the game look respectable, but it was pretty much over once it was 14-0, and the 49ers had turned it over several times. Several. Way too many turnovers for the 49ers. It's just been a long season, and it's a shame that they won't be able to go back to play for the Super Bowl again. Oh well. Bucks, Falcons. Now, here's something new. Oh wait, it's not new at all. It's the Falcons blowing another lead. They blew a 24-7 lead to Tom Brady and the Bucks. You don't let that happen. You just whatever. It's the Falcons. Go away. Go away, Falcons fans. Go away. Just go somewhere and stay there until the season's over, because, man, this is pathetic. How many blown leads has it been this year? Like 4 or 5? Inexplicable. Inexplicable. The Ravens put a whooping on the Jags, and now the Jags have the number one seed, or rather the number one draft pick, I almost said. I don't know why I said number one seed. They have the number one draft pick now. So there's that. Trevor coming to Jacksonville, the home of AEW. Ooh, it could be interesting. But alas, we do have to tell another team goodbye, and that is the New England Patriots. Goodbye, Patriots. The Dolphins have eliminated you from playoff contention. It's been a long time since we've had no New England Patriots in the playoffs. And that was the year Tom Brady, you know, got injured. No Patriots in the postseason. So the Dolphins did it again. Ruined the Patriots. Just ruined the Patriots' year. You know, last year they did it with a big win on the last week of the regular season. Now they've done it today with a huge win. You know, gritty, grinded out type win. You know that Dolphins defense is tough. So what about the Seattle-Washington game? Again, the Cowboys are still alive. The Eagles are still alive too, and the Giants are still alive as well. But it's Washington's division to lose, and they are slipping. You know, you cannot afford a loss if you're the football team. And that's just exactly what happened. It may have been a slugfest against the Seahawks, but Seahawks got the W, and they have a playoff spot. So good for the Seahawks. They've clinched another postseason appearance. You just can't keep those guys away from the postseason. You just can't. Can't at all. So, how about those Bears, though? The Bears are back in the playoff hunt themselves. They beat the Vikings. There's no reason to really watch that Christmas Day game now. The Vikings are on the outside looking in, and they are not looking pretty right now. You know, and I mean, to be completely honest, we could go ahead and throw the Vikings in the elimination bin too, pretty much. But I mean, not just yet, not just yet. There's still a couple weeks left, not just yet. So, how about Lions Titans? No way, Derrick Henry just probably stiff-armed me to hell, so there's no point talking about this game. I mean, the Titans just blew out the Lions. Blew them out. Put them out their misery. You know, just rough. So, also, we just had the same conversation 2 weeks ago with the Texans. They fumbled it away again against the Colts. This is literally the exact same score, pretty much, from 2 weeks ago. God, there's got to be some fixing for the Texans in the offseason. This is rough to watch. What about the Bills? Oh, you know, since the Patriots lost, hey, the Bills said, hey, let's just lock up the AFC East tonight, and let's get it done and over with. And so it was done. Josh Allen and company have locked up the AFC East for the first time in, what, a quarter of a century? Just bullied the Broncos. We're talking bully them. I mean, it was just rough out there for the Broncos. The Broncos are done with their playoff hopes as well. They are now pretty much eliminated, along with the Panthers, who gave a pretty good fight to the Packers. They gave them a pretty good fight, but it's unfortunate. Panthers lose. Panthers do not go to the playoffs. So, they will not be going to the playoffs this year. And what about those Raiders? What about the Raiders of Las Vegas? For a team that allows 30 points per game, that is pretty accurate because the Chargers beat you in overtime, 30-27, damaging your playoff hopes. And this is not a new thing, too, for the Raiders. They collapsed late last year as well. They had a good start, and they started to collapse late. You know, the Raiders just have not had it good. I mean, they got blasted by the Colts last week, and they lose in a bizarre fashion this week. I mean, both teams were trying to hand the ball away, you know, trying to not win this game. And it ended up being the Chargers, who did not choke for once. So, yeah. So, there we go. Week 15, it is done. Week 16, I'll have a video coming out probably Thursday instead of, you know, Tuesday and Wednesday. It'll be Thursday instead. I think I'll do something else for Wednesday. Because of the Friday game, you know, being there. And, I mean, a lot of playoff spots are looking like they're going to be locked up this week, thus ensuring that Week 17 is going to look, you know, like the Premier League, where they have all their big matchups at the same time, not just the one matchup on Sunday Night Football, you know, late. It's going to be like 2017 or 2018 all over again, I think. Whichever year it was, where we had, you know, all the games at either one, all the games that didn't matter at one, and all the games that did matter for playoff implications at four. But yeah, week 16 is looking kind of rough for the most part. I mean, yeah, there's a Saturday game that looks interesting. There's, you know, some stuff on Amazon. Yeah, that's right, Amazon. Sunday and Monday night, you know, Monday night doesn't matter, and most of Saturday doesn't matter either. Neither does really Friday. But I won't talk about that today. I'll talk about that in a couple of days. So, week 15, is your team still alive in the playoff hunt? You know, talk to me. Tell me something more that I missed, because I know I missed something. I miss a lot of things, you know, when it comes to the NFL. So, you know, sound off in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video. Y'all take care. Have a good night.